All right. You can keep it. Oh, is it loud? All right, coming back into order from a short recess after recognizing Officer Scott South. All right. We'll go through the agenda. Any comments by visitors this evening? Okay. Seeing none, any comments by board members to start? Seeing none, we'll move to the consent calendar, which are our school board meetings from February 13th. What's the wish of the board to adopt the consent calendar?
Make a motion to adopt the consent calendar.
Second.
Okay. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All right, the consent calendar is adopted. Reports, I don't believe there are any reports this evening at all, but there are committee reports. Yep. So no reports, informational. We'll move to committee reports for our standing committee, budget and revenue committee.
Thank you, Madam Chair. The budget and revenue committee has not met since our last board meeting.
Okay. Thank you. Building, grounds, and transportation committee. Board member Clark.
Yeah. So building, grounds, and transportation has not met since we last meted. It's not the right word. Met. Okay. Our next meeting is May 6th at 5:15.
May?
March.
Oh, okay. Yes.
Yeah, March.
That's all right. We'll keep going. It's a lot.
We're going to meet in March.
Educational Programs and Community Outreach Committee, O'Brien Hart. Thanks.
Thank you. The Educational Programs Committee met on the 20th, which was Tuesday. We got an update on the student-based SBHC, Student-Based Health Center. Wait, School-Based Health Center. Sorry, late.
For students.
The SBHC, and it's up and operating, and the schedule is booked for mental health services, like, fully all day, so they've come up to capacity there. Those services are available a few days a week, and then another day for wellness. The wellness services, like, people still are kind of learning about those opportunities, so those aren't as booked. It's nice to hear also, though, that there is possibility for growth if needed, you know, depending on what Avis Goodwin would decide and all of that. But so that's great, very successful. The committee was talking about student cell phone use, and I think administrators are working with the policy committee on developing a policy for student cell phone use at the high school. So there's that. And then we really wanted to make a priority, especially for our next meeting, brainstorming ways to increase community engagement and increase student attendance and work on that issue. So that will be that was something we discussed some ideas for at this last meeting, and we'll be discussing at the upcoming meeting next month. So.
Thank you so much. Appreciate that. And our policy committee, Board Member Tierney.
Thank you, Madam Chair. The Policy Committee hasn't met since our last school board meeting, but we will be meeting on March 5th at 5:45 in the SAU office.
Great. There's no presentation this evening. We'll move into policy adoption. There's no policies for first reading. There is one policy for second reading, IC, the school year. It's been read one time, so we'd like to, go ahead. And
policy IC, school year.
Okay. And what was the change with this, just in brief?
Go ahead. You want?
I'm trying to remember what you talked about last.
Your policy stated you had 180.
Yeah, we updated the number of days. Yep.
Right, changed the number of days. And then there was an item that you asked me to look into, which I did.
Yeah.
And there's a reference to it in the packet.
The State Board of Education.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I was asked to look at. I'll read it for any days that the schools are closed for emergency reasons we made up at the end of the school year or during recess periods as provided by the board upon the superintendent's recommendation. Under special circumstances, the board may request an exception to this requirement from the State Board of Education. That's who you make the request to.
Yeah. So just to clarify that, there was no change from the first reading other than superintendent updating the State Board of Education.
Right.
Okay. And we have 177 days?
Yeah, so you had 180, and I think the last time the policy was looked at was in...
No, sorry, I think it was 180, and now it's 177.
I say.
Yeah.
It was one...
So it's now 177.
Correct.
That's the more accurate
update.
Right,
yeah.
Right, and also there are, instead of five, there are eight additional days for teaching staff for their PD.
Okay.
But the total of 190 days is unchanged.
Oh, okay, wonderful. Thank you for the update. All right, any other questions from this? All right, what's the wish of the board to adopt policy IC school year?
Motion to adopt.
Okay. All right, any discussion? All right, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All right, IC is adopted. Thank you for the work on that and the clarification.
Thank you.
There's no new business this evening. We do have old unfinished business. This is why we are here on a Thursday for the second read of the vote to forward the fiscal year 25 tax cap budget to the city manager. Looking for a motion to be able to. Oh, yes. Thanks, Lou.
Madam Chair.
Yep.
So can we just clarify sort of the next steps? Because I think based on our previous discussions, I think the understanding is that this budget that we need to say to approve to move forward to the city is the tax cap budget as required per the city law.
Yep.
Law, is that the right charter? Mm-hmm. And there's this sort of general feeling that, well, we'd like to see if the city council, you know, what might happen next, right? So, like, I guess the understanding, I think, is we all, like, this motion that we make now is to approve the budget as presented, as required to be presented, meeting the tax cap, which I think none of us are thrilled with, but that, just so to be clear, like, that's what we're saying yes to. And then maybe just to clarify, like, what happens then?
Well, it's a regretful moving forward, right? Like, we are endorsing the superintendent's recommended tax cap budget to the city council. This isn't an endorsement or support of the budget as presented. This is the motion to recommend, move it forward to the city council for March 1st, which is outlined in the charter. So it's a tough one because I don't think this board is approving the budget and supporting what this is, but we are in line with the fiscal responsibility to that number to meet the tax cap number to be able to move forward for March 1st.
So question.
Yep.
What if, I just want to understand the process here, hypothetical. What if we all are like, nope, this is not going anywhere right now? Then what happens?
We are required by city charter to propose our budget by March 1st to the city manager.
Yeah.
That is by charter. We have to give them a budget.
So right.
You're not approving the budget.
Yep.
You're approving sending it to the city manager to be included in the city's budget.
Right.
Then once their process happens,
mm-hmm.
then it comes back to this board
mm-hmm.
to finally approve
yeah.
the budget.
So it's a procedural, it's a procedural vote that we're making now that we have to make. Yeah, so I was just kind of curious.
So the same memos that I have done with our recommended budget
yep.
as we would like to see it, will go to the city tomorrow
mm-hmm.
Along with the proposal with the tax cap. So it's going to be the same format, like this is what we want.
Yep.
And this is how we got to the tax cap budget.
Yep.
So they'll have all of that information.
Okay.
The recommended versus the tax cap.
All right, good. Thank you.
And then you'll begin your process with the council, and when they get the budget and begin their process as a whole,
okay.
we present to them again.
Yeah.
So it doesn't stop here.
Right.
We also have a presentation to council.
Yep.
Once they start their process, where you again can reiterate your hope for an override, that's where the process happens.
All right. Thank you for the clarification.
You're welcome.
Yep. Do you want to read the first one?
Yeah. I move to endorse superintendent's recommended FY25 school district budget, but due to the city charter budget restrictions, not forward to the city manager.
Point of clarification,
mm-hmm.
This is not the superintendent's recommended budget.
This is. This is
I thought this
budget.
Says that budget is to be to be voted on is not the superintendent's recommended budget. That's what this says in the agenda right here. So my understanding was the recommended budget is the one that exceeds the tax cap.
So
right. So what we're saying now is the tax cap budget. Right? I'm harping on the word recommended just because I want to be absolutely clear what we're
endorsing here. The recommended budget, but we're forwarding on the tax cap budget to the city manager, just for the clarity, right? So this is, because it could be very unclear if we said we are endorsing the tax cap budget. Yes, Board Member Marsh.
And I think I'll further clarify that unless changes are made, you know, in this process prior, right, we are endorsing the superintendent's recommended budget, but without change. Right. Because the school board has the ability to make changes, as we certainly did last year, from the superintendent's budget. But we are endorsing what was forwarded to us, which was put together by, based
folks,
on,
folks,
right, which was based on recommendations from building administrators, superintendent, and again, unless we make any changes, that's what we are recommending for the tax cap budget.
Can I just clarify your motion, though? Because the way it's worded, does that mean you don't want me to submit where our recommendation would be outside of the tax cap? Because that's how this
no,
reads.
No, but I think we're endorsing the budget, the superintendent's budget, but regretfully, we're endorsing that. But
it's a non-binding resolution, basically. Yep. It's a non-binding. You're making a statement. My sense is you're making a statement that you endorse what was proposed, but realize you can't move that forward, so you make a motion on the tax cap budget and say, here's what you're recommending. That's the way I see it, right?
Yeah, Board Member Brown.
Can I please have the motion reread so that I know that it captures that we are sending the tax cap budget in addition and additionally the recommended budget to the City Council for consideration?
I would say if you're going to do this, you separate the two. One is a non-binding, non-binding. It doesn't. You're not doing anything wrong. You're just saying you're expressing your sentiment as a board. The second motion is the motion that goes off to, the second motion is the motion that says you're, passing off the tax cap budget to the city manager.
Can I also speak to that proposal? Because I would prefer to see them tied as
together.
One
well,
you can, okay. motion because I don't want, I would like the motion to stand on its own and not have it divide and conquer. I don't think we're gonna change our votes, but I would like to, it sounds like our wish is to send a package and which contains two parts, and I would like to continue having one motion.
Okay.
That's fine.
Sorry.
So I would like to withdraw my motion currently. Thank you.
Yeah, okay. Let's try this. Okay. The motion to endorse the superintendent's recommended fiscal year 25 budget, but due to the charter budget restriction, regretfully move to forward the fiscal year 25 school district tax cap budget to the city manager. Or we could just we could regretfully move it, but in the same way, we're cutting $1.2 million. So if to say that we are, it's a hard motion because publicly, if we say we're endorsing the budget, but we're moving the tax cap budget along. Yep. Oh yes.
Could we just say we motion to move the budget package forward, which includes our endorsed budget, but also the budget which is the required budget under the tax cap forward.
Mm-hmm. So a motion to submit both the superintendent's recommended budget along with the tax cap budget to the city manager. Can we move both?
I'll second that.
Oh, okay. Oh,
okay.
I didn't make the motion yet. I wanted to allow you to. But did you make them? Did you want to try to respond with the motion?
I thought she made a motion, so that's why I seconded.
Okay.
If it wasn't a motion, I withdraw.
Katie, can you read that back? Did you?
Okay, we'll try again.
Yeah,
we'll try again. Yeah. Hold on. Let's just clarify this first, and then. Yep.
Okay.
On the spot.
I can remember all. I motion to move the superintendent's recommended budget along with the required tax cap budget together to City Hall.
The city manager. City manager.
The city manager.
Yep. Okay.
I second.
Second that.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Second. Okay. Any discussion? Board Member Marshall.
Oh, right. Thank you for that motion. My thought was going to be to we didn't necessarily need to use the word endorse, which you did not. So thank you.
Okay.
But briefly, I want to say that I have confidence that the city manager and the city council will review. Listen.
Just, sorry.
No, it's okay.
I feel like everyone's...
I can extend my comments.
Yes.
So, yeah. I have comments that the city manager and the city council, made up of representatives from the people of Somersworth, will review, listen to the people of Somersworth, all the people of Somersworth that present their views, deliberate, and make balanced decisions for our community, including our children. Thank you.
If I can also just reiterate Board Member Marsh's comment that I am glad to have the motion send both of these budgets for consideration to the City Council and City Manager. And I, too, welcome their participation and scrutiny and hopefully consideration of anything that can be higher than the tax cap budget.
I just wanted to actually thank Superintendent Kaczynski for presenting us with these two budgets. This is my second term on the board, and that's not what I've seen in the past. In the past, it was just, here's a budget, and we kind of work with it. And so I just really appreciate it for the perspective and the comparison that we could make. I don't know in the end where we'll all end up, but I just felt like it was really a very clear way to show, okay, here's what we need to do, and here's what would happen to meet this, our obligation, but here's what we're looking at in order, and again, as we've talked before, to maintain the status quo. So I appreciate that you brought those two, the two budgets forward. I thought it was helpful.
Yes, well, I am similar to what Todd and Marsha were mentioning about the city council. I feel like they recognize the hurdle that we're facing, and they recognize that we need to help keep some of our programs within the city. So I'm hopeful that they will help us figure this out, if it's raising the tax cap or figuring out another way. I'm encouraged by that, and I hope that the community is as well.
Yep. Yeah, I think I'm hearing, and as chair, I'm dedicated to finding a way through this. This is an agonizing budget. This sweeps our ability to provide an adequate education to our students. This is not a supportive budget to be able to maintain our district as it is, even as is. So I think we're dedicated. This is difficult to put forward this because it does seem real at this moment, but this is not the end of this budget discussion. This is not the end of advocacy and collaboration and working towards a solution. So this is the first step. So I appreciate everyone's, comment and work on that, but it's not over yet. And the vote is not over yet. There's a motion on the table to summarize, to forward both the superintendent's recommended budget, fiscal year 25, and the tax cap budget to the city manager. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All right. It's being forwarded, and we'll keep the work and dedication of making something work in the future for next year. All right. Future meeting dates, March 5th, policy, March 6th, building grounds, March 12th, policy and our board meeting, and March 19th, ed programs. Any comments by visitors this evening? All right. Any comments by board members? Yes, Brian, followed by Marsh.
So at the last board meeting, I called out to Ward 1 and said, hey, please give us your input on the budget. I didn't hear anything. And I just want to reiterate, anyone who has any comments on the budget, please support us as the school board, support the city council, inform them. If you have any support of the recommended budget, please do so. So I just want to make that call out that this is a public process. The documents are available for review, I would really appreciate having public support for the city council's decisions. Thank you.
I'll echo that. I'd been observing for quite some time councils and school boards making decisions, and what I have observed is that that representatives, I think really largely, do listen. They do absorb. They're not going to agree with everyone, and you know, what's the majority, what's the minority, but I think they listen and absorb. And so public reaching out to the city council, reaching out to school board members, reaching out to others in you know, state level, it does matter. I think sometimes elected officials, you know, even on, we can be viewed as some sort of, as if we're bureaucrats. You know, this is the school board of Somersworth, New Hampshire, where we are neighbors, right? So are the city councilors. Right, so public input does matter. Also, I want to say I hear that we have a new school board member, I am pleased that the people of the Ward 4 neighbor, Ward 5, have a representative. So I'm happy to hear that. And I want to thank the superintendent, building administrators, for putting together both budgets, right? Those are not, I view a budget as a policy statement, right? And they are not easy to develop and correct. We are not done yet. So I look forward to continuing the process. Thank you.
Yeah.
So on March 5th at the next policy meeting, we will be discussing the cell phone policy. And so I would like to just sort of put a call out there. I'd be curious to hear from the community. This will be specifically for high school. And we'll be looking at bringing the, what we'll be discussing is whether or not to bring we'll be discussing the high school policy in light of the elementary and middle school policies. They have a no cell phone policy currently. High school, of course, has a bit more flexibility with that. But I would love to hear community input. You know, parents of high schoolers, what do you think? The proposal, you know, on the table is basically to make cell phones, like the kids can't use them except for, you know, certain times in the day, or if the instructional time allows for it. So I just would love some, you know, any policies you can see, the current policies on the website, just look under school board. I can't remember all the drop down titles, but you can, yeah, school board policies, they're easily found. And so I encourage you to read the one for K through 8 and the one for 9 through 12, and just, you know, send your thoughts to your ward reps or me or the chair, you know, whoever. So just wanted to put that up there.
I just wanted to mention that Somersworth is not alone in looking at policy on cell phones. It's an issue that schools, districts across the country are looking at. So I just wanted to make that aware to folks that are a number of school boards across the country that are looking at their policies on cell phone use. I think the time has come to do that. I really do. So I look forward to meeting with the policy committee and hearing from the building principals in terms of what they see and deal with on a day-to-day basis with cell phone use. I just wanted to make that point as well. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you all. Looking for a motion to go into non-public. per our New Hampshire RSA 91A32B.
Motion to go into non-public per NHRSA 91-A:2A and A-3. Do I have to do them separately? Do I do them all?
All.
A:3A and C. Okay.
Oh, I don't know about that one.
You don't know about that one? I don't know what that one is.
Wait, hold on.
I don't know which one I need.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. Okay. Yeah, we're good. We're good. Okay. Leave now.
Maggie Larson.
Oh, yes.
Todd Marsh. Yes. Carrie Clark.
Yes.
Sarah O'Brien Hart.
Yes.
Crystal D. St. Croix.
Yes.
Marsha Brown.
Yes.
Susan Tierney.
Yes.